Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 36. Today I'm post-processing one of the photos I took on a dull, rainy day of a classic red T-bird that I happened to spy in a parking lot as I was driving down a street in my town. I managed to quickly pull off without creating any incidents on the road, but I saw it and I needed to get out and take a picture of it. So because I did my best to compose in camera, today's edit is a simple process, a few steps in Lightroom, a few in Color Effects Pro, and then followed by a final crop of the image and a discussion about when it's best to crop in your workflow. So here is the before image, and I'm going to come in, I'm going to knock this down, I'm going to come into my basics panel, and basically the first thing I did was increase my exposure, obviously, because it's highly underexposed, dull day, and then I'm going to increase the highlights as well a bit. Bring them up just a bit, and then I'm going to boost the clarity, which is like a micro contrast. It also darkens it back down just a little bit. So, and then as you saw, I knocked back my detail, my sharpening slider. I'm going to come in and come over to the Lightroom General Presets and hit Sharpen Scenic. And it does, I'm going to play with that, maybe sharpen faces so that it doesn't bring as much in as much noise. And from here, I am going to export this into Color Effects Pro, edit in. And for those of you who have followed my videos before, you know the process is that I edit a copy with the Lightroom adjustments. As Color Effects Pro opens, it creates a blank TIFF file in my film strip. Blank meaning that it replicates what you see on the screen here prior to its changes. And then it's to that file that the changes I make in Color Effects Pro will be brought back once I'm done. So here's the image brought in. I'm going to X out of this existing filter that loaded. And I am going to use, there's actually two filters simple in this process. They're two of my favorites, and I have actually starred them in the list. The first is Pro Contrast, and I'm going to come over here and click on the stack. And I like dynamic contrast. That's kind of my go-to. You'll see there's an auto enhance, and there's a strong contrast, which this one could have used it with the bump in saturation, but I'm going to leave it at the dynamic contrast. I can always bump up the saturation in Lightroom should I choose to do so. From here, I'm going to add another filter, and that is dark and light and center. So I come back, hit the back button, and I come back to the list, and I find that filter, which I have starred again. These two have a number of different presets. Here is the default, which is very subtle. And here is the maximum depth, which oftentimes I'll come here because then I can tweak the settings to my heart's desire, which I can on the other way. But this way, I start from too much instead of not enough. So on this one, I am going to decrease the center lumosity to about, I'm going to bring it down to about 60, and the border lumosity, I'm going to increase the brightness of that, I don't know, to about 65. Let's keep it in balance. Okay, and you can toggle off the effects. Here's if I remove the Pro Contrast filter, you can see the difference. It just makes the rain on this hood just pop, dark and light and center. And this, of course, acts as a vignette. I mean, that's what it is. It is a vignette, and it focuses your attention on this wonderful detail in on the hood of the car. So at this point, I'm done with what I want to do in Color Effects Pro. I'm going to hit Save, and the program is going to export it back into Lightroom and save those changes in that TIFF file. Here we go. There's the TIFF file. And there it is. Okay, and from here, the last thing I want to do is crop. Now, the reason I didn't crop before, and oftentimes, or I have learned, it's better to crop, for me anyway, and I'm assuming for everyone else, it's better to crop after you've post-processed your image. Why do I say that? Well, I have cropped an image, I've post-processed it, jumped through the hoops, and then realized after the fact that, you know, the crop just wasn't exactly where I wanted it to be. And so as a result, I needed to go back and start from scratch, which is not a good thing to do. If you wait until after post-processing to crop your photo, then you've got, you know, a wonderful full framed image that you can go back in and crop to your heart's content in any different number of ways. So for this, as I go into crop, I'm going to click on the crop circle or crop overlay tool, and I am going to unlock the aspect ratio because I just want to pull this down to about here. I want to put the logo in the top third, on the top third of the rule of thirds overlay. It's hard to see here. I don't know if you can see it, but the top line is about here. And then I want to center the logo. And to do that, I need to change the crop angle a bit. And I'm going to use the grid overlay to match up. Let's see. Well, I'm having a little bit of difficulty. Okay, I'm looking at the grid and trying to get the wing tips of the logo to match up with the grid lines. And then the center grid line, which is indicated here in the middle of this icon, which I've done. So there you go. I may add just a bit more of a vignette. I can come in and add a post-crop vignetting of minus 10. And there's the final image. I will show you the before. Let me come back to the before. So there is the before image. And there's the after. Much bigger improvement, and it really focuses your eye to what I found to be the most interesting of the image. So there you have it. For those of you watching on YouTube, if you want to see more after before galleries of photos, please visit visualventuring.com and look for After Before Friday Forum, where you will find quite a few links to quite a few of the of these galleries on my blog. All right, everybody, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments sections on YouTube or on my blog. And thanks for watching.